Hello everyone. In this video, we will continue further the topic Models of Corporate Governance, and we will discuss here Indian model of corporate governance. I am Madhu Verma and welcome you all at my YouTube channel Learning Academy, where learning and education is imparted in an easy way. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe it and press the bell icon for the new video updates. So let's understand Indian model of corporate governance. In the earlier video, we discussed German model of corporate governance. And here we will understand the Indian model of corporate governance. So let's have a brief overview and the introduction about the Indian model. The model of Indian corporate governance is a combination of both Anglo-American and German model. This is because in India, following three types of corporations are working: private companies, public companies, and public sector undertakings. And public under-sector undertakings are further off. It may be statutory companies, these may be the government companies, the banks, and other financial institutions. These are the different types of public sector undertakings. And each corporation has a distinct pattern of shareholding, means the private, public, and public sector undertaking. Each type of corporation has a distinct or different pattern of shareholding due to their composition. In India, in most of the cases, the company board is dominated by family members and founders because they have maximum shareholding of their companies. India, in most of the cases, mein, company board mein dominating members hoti hai, family members. They are called founders of business, kaha jata hai, jo business ko establish karte hai, because family members or founders ke paas a company ki maximum shareholding hoti hai. They are the owners of the maximum number of shares of the company. Isliye vah company board mein dominate karte hai. Promoters and his family members have almost complete control over the company. In private companies, dependence on outside capital is less. Hence, private companies follow the German model. So there is no instances of corporate failure in Indian companies due to systematic management of family promoters. Because Indian companies mein promoters or family members ka complete control hota hai company par, because unke paas maximum shareholding hai company ki, ye company ke owners hai. So private companies mein to outside capital par dependence bahut kam hai, because internal sources se hi capital arrange ki jati hai. Publicly shares ko sale nahi kiya jata, to wahan par German model ko follow kiya jata hai. Aur Indian companies mein instances of corporate failure बहुत कम होते हैं, because family promoters के द्वारा business को systematically manage किया जाता है, because they are the major shareholder of the company, उनको पता है जो भी profit organization run करेगा, वे उनके पास आएंगे, so वे business को successfully run करने की कोशिश करते हैं, so that they can earn maximum returns. Corporate governance structure differs in every company. However, there are some provisions of Companies Act 2013 and SEBI guidelines that the companies are required to fulfill. Some duties are legal while some are ethical. Corporate governance structure har ek type ki company mein alag hota hai, differ kar sakta hai. Lekin Companies Act 2013 aur SEBI guidelines hai jo ki har ek company ke liye required hai ki unko fulfill karni padengi, comply karni padengi. Kuch duties companies ki legal hai jo ki prescribed by law hai, aur kuch duties ethical hai that are based upon the moral grounds. So let's discuss what is the basic structure of corporate governance. The structure of corporate governance in India is composed of board composition, code of conduct, and board committees. And in board composition, what type of directors are included? It includes at least one resident director, at least one women director, at least one third of independent directors. And the code of conduct can be the formal written code of conduct or written code policy as per law. And what type of board committees are there? They are the audit committees, nomination and remuneration committee, stakeholder relationship committee, and corporate social responsibility committee. So this is the basic structure of corporate governance in India. We will discuss the board composition, code of conduct, and board committees, means all types of structures we will discuss in the further slides in more detail. Now we will understand what is the basic model of corporate governance in India. This is a company and in company. They are the shareholders. Shareholders own the shares of the company. Now the shareholders do not directly participate in the management of the company because ownership and management, these are the separate activities in Indian corporate sector. So the shareholders elect the board of directors to work on their behalf. The board of directors work as the representatives of the shareholders because they protect the money that has been invested by the shareholders. So the board of directors are elected by the shareholders, and there is the accountability of the board of directors toward the shareholders for performing the duties and for managing the money and the capital invested by the shareholders. Now the board of directors appoint the management, means they appoint different types of managers like production, marketing, sales, finance, and these are appointed by management. Here, board of directors helps the management in strategy formulation. They appoint the management and monitors the business activities. And management has accountability, and they will have to comply. They will have to ensure the compliance of all the laws and regulations, as well as they will have to protect the interest of the company. And labor, what is the role of labor here? Labor helps in the production that provides output, their skills and knowledge to the organization. Means labor is involved in the production activities that provide output to the organization, as well as the labor provides their knowledge and skills to the organization. And the company, with the help of management, gives them wages, better work environment and job satisfaction. And what is the role of customers? The organization, the company provides good quality goods and services to the customers. So the customers expect from the organization, from the companies, that the good quality products and services. As well as the company demands from the customers loyalty and retention, means the customers will stay with the business. They will continue with purchasing the products of the company. Suppliers, what is the role of suppliers here? Suppliers ensure regular supply of material that are required by the organization to carry on its production activities. So suppliers provide timely regular supply of the materials, raw material, it may be work in progress or finished goods to the organization. And the management ensures, the company ensures good business terms, means while dealing with the suppliers, the company ensures the suppliers that it is doing the business on the good business terms, and it also ensures the timely payments to the suppliers for the supply of the goods and services, for the supply of the material to the organization. What is the role of society here? There is a social responsibility of the companies towards the society, means they will have to fulfill their social responsibility towards the society because the society also contributing to the business. So the society also participates in the management of the company because many employees are working in the organization. Those are the part of the society, as well as the business organization take many things from the society. That's why there is some social obligation of the organization or the companies towards the society that they will have to fulfill. And what is the role of government and regulatory authorities? Government and regulatory authorities formulates the rules, laws that the business organization will have to comply with. Capital market. Any business organization or the company will have to work in the capital market where the sale and purchase of the shares are held, and there is a competition in the capital market because there are many companies which are working with which the company will have to compete. So capital market provides competition to the company. So this is the basic model of Indian model of corporate governance. This is a basic structure through which the Indian corporations work, and the laws and regulations are prescribed for each type of the for each level of the structure. Here we will understand The board composition. What is the board composition in Indian model? The Companies Act 2013 lays greater emphasis on governance through board and board processes. There are following provisions with regard to composition of board in a company. A company must have at least one resident director on its board. Having resident director in board emphasizes that the board is not composed of only non-resident directors. Means Indian model mein, Indian companies mein composition of board kya hona chahiye? Means board mein kis kis tarah ke members include kiye jane chahiye board of directors mein. So first point hai ki company ke board composition mein ek resident director zarur hona chahiye. At least one resident director should be there. यह emphasize करता है एक resident director को होना कि board of directors में सिर्फ non-resident directors ही नहीं है, एक resident director भी होना essential है. Next is a listed company must appoint a women director also. एक listed company को एक women director भी appoint करना चाहिए organization में. A women director's appointment, this provision has been set in accordance with the hot issue of women empowerment. Women empowerment को emphasize करने के लिए women director के appointment को का provision इसमें include किया गया. This also provides that the dominance of male members only is not continued in future. A listed company must have at least one third of its directors as independent directors. And nominee directors are no longer considered as independent director. Listed company में कम से कम one third director independent directors होने चाहिए. इसके अलावा a company can appoint maximum 15 directors in its board. This limit may be increased by passing a special resolution. एक कंपनी बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स में मैक्सिमम 15 मेंबर्स 15 डायरेक्टर्स को अपॉइंट कर सकती है, लेकिन इस लिमिट को इंक्रीज किया जा सकता है जिसके लिए कंपनी को एक स्पेशल रेजोल्यूशन अपनी मीटिंग में पास करना पड़ता है, उसके द्वारा इस लिमिट को इंक्रीज किया जा सकता है. एंड द कंपनीज एक्ट 2013 हैव वर्कड फॉर इनहांसिंग इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स. इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स आर रीडिफाइंड इन दिस एक्ट. कंपनीज एक्ट में इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स के राइट्स को इनहांस करने के लिए भी प्रोविजंस प्रोवाइड किए गए हैं. मींस एक्ट में इनको रीडिफाइन किया गया है. व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स इन इंडियन मॉडल? द इंडियन कंपनीज एक्ट 2013 हैज कोडिफाइड द फंक्शंस एंड रोल ऑफ बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स एंड फॉलोइंग आर द मेन ड्यूटीज ऑफ द डायरेक्टर्स इन इंडियन मॉडल. द फर्स्ट इज टू एक्ट इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द कंपनीज आर्टिकल्स. बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स को कंपनी के आर्टिकल्स ऑफ एसोसिएशन के अकॉर्डिंग काम करना है. आर्टिकल्स ऑफ एसोसिएशन जो कि एक बेसिक फ्रेमवर्क प्रोवाइड करते हैं कंपनीज की एक्टिविटीज का, और बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स से ये एक्सपेक्ट किया जाता है वे कंपनी के आर्टिकल्स ऑफ एसोसिएशन के अकॉर्डिंग काम करेंगे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में. टू एक्ट इन द बेस्ट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द कंपनी एज अ होल, ही और शी शुड नॉट वर्क इन द बेस्ट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ शेयर होल्डर. ही शुड वर्क इन द बेस्ट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ शेयर होल्डर. बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स से यह भी एक्सपेक्ट किया जाता है वह कंपनी के बेस्ट, कंपनी के हितों की रक्षा के लिए काम करेंगे, और इसके अलावा शेयर होल्डर्स के इंटरेस्ट को भी प्रोटेक्ट करेंगे. बिकॉज द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स आर अपॉइंटेड बेसिकली दे आर द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द शेयर होल्डर्स. बिकॉज शेयर होल्डर्स डू नॉट डायरेक्टली पार्टिसिपेट इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी, सो ऑन देयर बिहाफ द बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स वर्क इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. दे मैनेज द बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज, द डे टू डे रनिंग ऑफ द बिजनेस. So they should also work in the best interest of shareholders. To perform assigned duties with reasonable care, skill and diligence. He should not indulge in a situation where there exists a direct conflict of interest between him and the company. इसके अलावा बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स से यह भी एक्सपेक्ट किया जाता है कि उनको किसी भी ऐसे सिचुएशन में इन्वॉल्व नहीं होना जहां पर कंपनी और डायरेक्टर्स के इंटरेस्ट के बीच में कंफ्लिक्टिंग सिचुएशन अराइज हो. ही शुड नॉट अटेम्प्ट टू अचीव एनी अनफेयर एडवांटेज फॉर हिमसेल्फ और हिज रिलेटिव्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस द ड्यूटीज ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स हैव आल्सो बीन स्टेटेड. ही शुड ऑफर इंडिपेंडेंट जजमेंट ऑन इश्यूज ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज. ही शुड ऑब्जेक्टिवली इवेल्युएट द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द बोर्ड. इसके अलावा इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स की ड्यूटीज को भी स्टेट किया गया. इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर एज इट्स नेम सजेस्ट मींस इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर को इंडिपेंडेंटली वर्क करना है, बायस्ड बिहेवियर नहीं होना चाहिए. सो इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर को अपने इंडिपेंडेंट जजमेंट देनी है इश्यूज ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज में, जिसमें कि किसी के लिए फेवरेटिज्म नहीं आएगा, किसी के लिए बायसनेस नहीं आएगी. कंपनी के फेवर में वह काम करेंगे और अपने इंडिपेंडेंट जजमेंट देंगे जो भी इश्यूज हैं, स्ट्रेटजीज हैं जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में फ्रेम आउट की जा रही हैं. और इसके अलावा बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स की परफॉर्मेंस को भी ऑब्जेक्टिवली इवेल्युएट करना, दैट इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ independent directors. What is the code of conduct in Indian model of corporate governance? There are two types of code. The first one is formal written code of conduct. Formal written code of conduct is based upon honestly and ethical business conduct. It provides equal opportunity workplace to everyone and safety at the workplace. And second one is written code policy as per law. This has been prescribed as per the law, and this is a written code, and it includes written code and policy to prevent insider trading. What is there are some written code and policies in the law that prevent insider trading. Means insider trading refers to the practice of purchasing or selling a publicly traded company's securities while in possession of material information. मीन्स जो कंपनी के इंटरनल पीपल है, जिनके पास कंपनी की मटेरियल इंफॉर्मेशन है, और वह उस इंफॉर्मेशन को किसी दूसरे पर्सन को बताते हैं जिसके द्वारा वह कंपनी के शेयर्स को परचेज या सेल की जा सकती है. और वह मटेरियल इंफॉर्मेशन अभी पब्लिक इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं बनी है. मीन्स उसको पब्लिकली डिस्क्लोज नहीं किया गया, लेकिन कुछ कंपनी के इनसाइडर्स हैं या फिर कुछ ऐसे पर्सन हैं जिनके पास वह इंफॉर्मेशन है, और वह उसको किसी पर्सन को डिस्क्लोज करते हैं या फिर खुद उस इंफॉर्मेशन का बेनिफिट लेते हैं, जिसके द्वारा परचेजिंग या सेलिंग की जाती है पब्लिकली ट्रेडेड कंपनीज की सिक्योरिटीज की, एंड दैट इज एन इलीगल प्रैक्टिस. So there is a written code and policy in the as per law that prevents such type of practices in the business organizations. Second is prohibition against short selling of company securities. There is also a prohibition. There is a prohibition regarding short selling. So what is short selling here? Short selling means an investor borrows a stock, then sells the stock, and then buys the stock again to return it to the lender. So here the investor sells a share that he does not own at the time of trade, and this is also not a permissible activity. So there is also a prohibition against short selling of the company's securities by any one of the shareholders. And there is also a written code and policy for free and fair competition. Means there should not be restrictions on the competition. A company should not practice the monopoly practices in the market. There should be a fair competition in the market, and financial reporting and accounting requirements. Except that there are some financial reporting requirements, accounting requirements. Mean the organization will have to prepare the financial reports. They will have to disclose the reports that have been prescribed in the Companies Act 2013, and every company will have to comply with those laws. So this is the code of conduct, formal written code of conduct, and a written code policy as per law. Here we will discuss what are the board committees in Indian model. The Companies Act 2013 includes the provisions of setup of four types of committees. What are these committees? These are audit committee. So Indian Companies Act 2013 में जो कि Indian corporations को govern करता है, उसमें four types की committees के लिए एक provision formulate किया गया है. कौन कौन सी committees हैं? First है audit committee. Audit committee का क्या role है? The board of every listed company should constitute an audit committee with minimum of three independent directors. With three directors, an independent director should be in majority in such committee. हर एक company को, जो भी लिस्टेड कंपनीज हैं, उनको एक ऑडिट कमेटी फॉर्मुलेट करनी है जिसमें कम से कम तीन डायरेक्टर होने चाहिए, और उस कमेटी में इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर मेजोरिटी में होने चाहिए. मींस अगर मिनिमम थ्री है, एटलीस्ट टू शुड बी द इंडिपेंडेंट डायरेक्टर्स इन द ऑडिट कमेटी, बिकॉज दे विल प्रोवाइड अ इंडिपेंडेंट जजमेंट. दैट जजमेंट विल नॉट बी बेस्ड अपॉन द बायसनेस. They will not favor the organization. That will be a fair and independent judgment. That's why there should be majority of the independent directors in the audit committee. Next is the committee regarding the nomination and remuneration committee. What is this committee? It identify eligible candidate for the directors. यह कमेटी आइडेंटिफाई करती है कि कौन कौन से एलिजिबल कैंडिडेट हैं जो कि एज अ डायरेक्टर अपॉइंट किए जा सकते हैं. रिकमेंडेशन टू बोर्ड फॉर अपॉइंटमेंट, फिर बोर्ड को उनके नेम्स रिकमेंड किए जाते हैं अपॉइंटमेंट के लिए. इवेल्युएट परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, इसके अलावा डायरेक्टर्स की परफॉर्मेंस को इवेल्युएट करते हैं. दिस कमेटी मस्ट हैव एटलीस्ट 3 or more नॉन एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर्स. Next committee is stakeholder relationship committee. If a company has more than 1000 shareholders, debenture holders and many other securities, then it must constitute this committee, and the purpose of this committee is to redress grievances of stakeholders. Agar ek company mein 1000 se zyada shareholders, debenture holders hain, tab उस कंपनी को कॉन्स्टिट्यूट करना चाहिए इस कमेटी को. और इस कमेटी का पर्पस क्या है, जैसे कि इसके नेम से क्लियर है, स्टेक होल्डर रिलेशनशिप कमेटी. द पर्पस ऑफ दिस कमेटी इज टू रिड्रेस द ग्रीवेंसेज ऑफ शेयर होल्डर्स, मीन जो शेयर होल्डर्स की शिकायतें हैं या फिर शेयर होल्डर्स जो भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से इंटरेक्ट करना चाहते हैं, ताकि शेयर स्टेक होल्डर्स के साथ एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के रिलेशनशिप्स अच्छे बने. रिलेशनशिप्स कब अच्छे बनेंगे, जब जो भी बात इनका पार्टिसिपेशन होगा एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, मींस उनकी बात को सुना जाएगा, जो उनके ग्रीवेंसेस है उनको रिड्रेस किया जाएगा. तो देयर शुड बी अ कमेटी फॉर द रिड्रेसल ऑफ द ग्रीवेंसेस ऑफ द स्टेक होल्डर्स. एंड कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी कमेटी. द प्रिंसिपल पर्पज ऑफ दिस कमेटी इज टू प्रिपेयर अ रिपोर्ट ऑन द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द कंपनी रिगार्डिंग फुलफिलिंग कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. इस कमेटी की फॉर्मुलेशन का पर्पस क्या है, ताकि कंपनी एक रिपोर्ट प्रिपेयर कर सके किसके रिगार्डिंग, कि कंपनी की क्या क्या कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज हैं और कंपनी उनको फुलफिल कर रही है या नहीं कर रही, और किन किन एस्पेक्ट्स में सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फुलफिल की जा रही है. दिस रिपोर्ट मस्ट ऑल्सो स्टेट विच प्रोविजन ऑफ द एक्ट वर नॉट कम्प्लाइड एंड वाई. यह कमेटी यह भी स्टेट करती है कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में जो कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी के रिगार्डिंग प्रोविजंस हैं कंपनीज एक्ट 2013 में, क्या कंपनी ने उन प्रोविजंस को कंप्लाई किया है, और अगर नहीं कंप्लाई किया तो क्या रीजंस हैं कि इसकी वजह से कंप्लाई नहीं किया गया, सो दैट द कंपनी मे फुलफिल इट्स कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी वेरी वेल. So these are the 4 types of board committees in Indian model of corporate governance, that is audit committee, nomination and remuneration committee, stakeholder relationship committee and corporate social responsibility committee. So this is the Indian model. I hope you must have understood this model very well, and also watch all the related videos of models of corporate governance like Anglo-US model, Japanese model and German model of corporate governance, to have a better understanding, to have a complete understanding about the models of corporate governance. So thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like the video and share it with your friends. And please give your comments in the comment box about how did you like the video.